Hey.
Yo.
Hey.
Yo.
Hey.
I ended it.
Damn it.
I decided to be the bigger man there.
Fair enough. How's it going, everybody?
I'm having an apple.
Sampy 104. Yeah, we do. You're runners. Lure fans are runners.
Yeah, the runners.
The loading ready runners.
Yeah.
Although Lurverts is a little weird, but
the Lurverts?
That's what he's suggesting.
Hmm, I don't know about that. We got a Matt in the chat.
Boo.
We got chat Matt. What's what the boo Matt?
I don't know.
Why you boo Matt? We got a Maya in the chat as well.
Yay!
One of those people is a mod.
Dominated. Wait, Matt doesn't have mod?
No.
That's funny.
I'll give him mod. Where's he at?
That seems worse than giving Maya mod. Matt doesn't do well with power.
What are you going to do?
Who knows?
Lord Husk, I don't know why Lurbot wouldn't recognize you as a mod. Sometimes it takes a sec. It's like sometimes when you say, oh no, he is a mod.
He
okay.
Is, yeah.
Sorry, sometimes it...
you love me, Matt.
Sometimes when you start typing, it doesn't see that you're a mod right away. So. So we're going to do the goofy one today.
Did you open up the notifier thing?
Oh, no, I didn't. I'll do that. Talk about the goofy one while I eat this apple.
So we're going to draft Triple BNG because it's not going to be around for very long. And it's kind of a wacky thing.
Uh-huh.
I mean, that's kind of our thing, right?
Uh-huh.
We're wacky wackies. So we're just going to do that. It gives us a really good chance at drafting Chromanticore,
yep.
Which we absolutely want to do.
Uh-huh.
And which will basically be on constant lookout in our Academy videos. Like, basically, every Academy video is draft the Chromanticore deck, if possible. And then when it happens, we're good to
wait.
Go.
No, not that. There we go. Yeah.
And there's a lot of other wacky things you could do with this. Whoa, that was fast. Oh, somebody left.
I recognize some of those names.
You sneaky people. Chromanticore all the way. I really want to go, like, as many loyal Pegasuses as possible. Damn.
I don't know. Faded Conflagration is pretty good. Boomp. Yeah. Didn't that used to fit better? I don't know. This guy's real, by the way.
Yeah, he's
I like
super
the snake.
Good.
So, Skyguard's good, Bolt is good, that's good. I'll probably just take that. This thing's real good. F this card. I mean, this card's great when I have one. It sucks when the other guy does.
One diamond for Magic the Gathering.
How do we do that?
I have no idea.
Chromanticore top 8 at an event? Sweet.
Nice.
Yeah, no, Skyguard's super strong. He's like Wingsteed Rider's little brother. Oh, little brother. Great Godom. The name Loading Ready Run comes from the Retract Helix.
Nice.
Relevant joke. The name Loading Ready Run comes from the old Commodore 64 computer system. That's what it would tell you when it was ready to fire off a... when it was ready to load an application. You would say loading. Or no, it would say loading, and then it would say ready, and then you would say...
So we're red run. Now?
I mean, at least partly.
Loyal Pegasus. Done. Slam it.
Ding. We're just going to go Triangle Mono Pegasus.
I really want to, because I think that'd be hilarious.
It's pretty good.
And it's a common, so we should be able to see a few of them.
I want
to
talk about this card on the next tap. Not the next tap that you guys hear, because we've already recorded that, but the next one that we record. Because some people don't like this card. And I have, frankly, I have scumbagged wins with that card, and I've had wins horrifically scumbagged on me with that card. And the games where I didn't cast it, where I still had it in my hand, are games I was winning anyway. So,
I don't know.
I think it's good. I've just heard some people be like, eh. I've heard people say it's bad.
If people say it's bad. People say any pump spell that isn't an instant is bad, right?
That's true. But
like, that's just, it all...
But
like,
this thing's huge.
They all get that. So,
for example, I think I already talked about when Matt crushed me at the in our sealed event with that thing.
The Rickroller? He's okay.
Nextborn Rickroller? Eh.
Skyguard?
I guess we take a Skyguard. This thing's worth a couple tickets. Like three.
Man, I kind of wish we had taken the first Skyguard.
I know, right? Double Skyguard and Pegasus?
And Pegasus, yeah.
Cool. Artemis Huntress. I was using that term to be like winning a game I have no right to win, or them winning a game that they had no right to win. Like, everything was like it wasn't necessarily that I couldn't win the game, but I shouldn't have won the game on that turn. And the times when I've lost to it, it's like, okay, I'm going to attack with these guys. He can only do so much damage. And then suddenly it's like, oh, there's actually 8 more power on the board. I am actually just dead. Damn. Well. Yeah, Thunderbrute, sweet, but let's take this guy. These are all dumb.
These are all terrible cards.
They're not. Like, this is fine. This guy's good. This is too expensive. This is too expensive. This guy's fine for the curve. This guy's good. Probably just take a piker. Maybe not a red piker. Maybe this piker. Ooh, Boofinka just posted a Steam code for the Introversion Complete Pack. That's pretty sweet. I don't know. What do you guys think? Acolyte's Reward.
Prospero. Well, Enlarge gave Trample. Mm-hmm. So that made Enlarge significantly better. Sure, take a Lancer.
Lancer, which one?
Or the 2-1, the Rowler.
Alright. I like the Black Piker. He's good. Oh, sweet. This guy's great. Guy's great.
I think I like the Skirmisher more. It depends on what our
deck is. This guy's so annoying.
Yeah, I like that guy a lot.
I like this guy too. He puts in the beats. I don't know. See what they say, Skirmisher RE Sun Guide. Versus Sun Guide. I'm gonna fix our caption.
Take the Griffin. Ooh, wait. Where are you guys?
That's the last pack.
Reward is 6, Skirmisher, Cat Bear, Sun God, Skirmisher, Mind Reaver, Skirmisher, Sun God. It's about even, but Sun I think there's a little bit. Yeah, Sun God is like... I like Sun God, but...
Take it Excoriate.
Yeah.
Just kill a thing. This guy's bad. This is okay. This is actually pretty all right, but let's take the Excoriate. Nothing like some good hard removal. I like the Sun Guide.
I like the Sun Chaser in the Loyal Pegasus deck. Because it'll let you attack for 3 on turn 2.
It does. That's true, but...
I mean, it's a silly card for a silly deck. It's not a good card.
This one.
Yeah.
This one better than this one. This one better. I like this one. Yeah. Also, you can pick up Rickrollers pretty late. Alright, sure. 2-2 haste. Like, the Scribe, we probably won't activate in this deck, but 2-2 haste for 3. I'd prefer a 2-2 haste for 3 than a 1-1 flying haste must attack every turn for 2. I don't know. What do you think?
Yeah, that's fine with that.
Alright. What the... I'm taking that. That is late. That is too late.
It's triple Born of the Gods. It doesn't count.
It's too damn late.
It's weird.
What, this?
No, just this format.
Oh, yeah.
People are doing weird things. We'll take
this or this. I guess Mortal's Ardor is pretty good, too.
I think we probably actually want to take that for an deck.
Oh, this is so good, though. This card's so good. All right, we'll take Mortal's Ardor. These are all poop. Well, this guy's fine, but the rest of them are poop. I guess I'll just cut white. Get out of the deck. Sure.
Ugh, the card. Boo.
This guy's so poopy.
Go, my reaver.
Cut the rare. And Culling Mark. All right.
There is no Helix speak in this chat.
Well, that guy, it is called a retraction Helix.
That's true.
Being incinerated by the sun.
Mm-hmm. All right, Chromanticore.
We're not in that deck.
We have to switch to that deck. Ooh.
I wish we were in that deck.
There's another Skyguard.
Another snake. So
it's actually very similar to the...
Nick Smith, Skyguard, Bolt. Those are all very good. That's a tough call, actually.
Pitcher.
We need some more targeting effects, but I can see taking a second Skyguard. The Bolt's really good, too. I'm open to input. I am glimpsing the Sun God. It's right in my friggin' eyes.
Nyx or Bolt?
No, God Favored General's not that good.
Take the Bolt.
All right. I like having Bolts. Removal, good stuff. No, not the General. If the General gets in, he's fine, but then you're paying 5 mana for 3/1s.
Silly Bolt. And why is this so expensive?
And he probably isn't getting in. What, this?
Yeah.
Because removal's slow in this format. Drum? This isn't even remotely a Springleaf Drum deck.
Nobody plays that card.
Actually, that's a lie. I've seen that card played against me to great effect. Oh, snap! I don't know what I want. People were using Springleaf Drum to like tap their inspired guys without actually attacking.
Yeah. The Eidolon, I think.
This thing's so good though. I've seen it go way later than it should, but it's really good. But yeah, this thing's just a disgusting beating.
Super bonkers.
Yeah. Alright. That is rough.
Well, everybody's saying phalanx though. Maybe that's better.
I think it's really close.
B Money Penny just subscribed.
B Money Penny.
Oh yeah, my bag is here.
Thank you for subscribing. Ah, the Sun God, why?
Woo, B Money Penny. Chilling
ding,
in my bag.
Ding.
Getting
ding.
Another loyal Pegasus. Yes. We gotta get 4. That's the goal.
Let me try it again. B Money Penny, thank you for subscribing.
Thank you, B Money Penny, for subscribing.
Welcome to the runners, I guess. I don't know.
That card actually just ruins us.
It really does. That's why I'm like, So we could take a second Excoriate. We could take this doof. This thing not so great. And cut Drowned Sorrow because it basically kills everything. Like, literally every creature we have, except the Griffin Dreamfinder, which we're probably not running.
Driftwood, you're not a sub. Or at least you aren't a sub anymore. There would be an arrow next to your name if you were subscribed to our channel. You shut your face, Maya. I did a fantastic job of welcoming you. It was glorious.
Welcome to Grain Being Slowly Incinerated, Eyeballs First. All right, quick, James. Excoriate or Cut the Drown?
Cut the Drown.
All right.
So
this thing's fine, but...
Oh, I like that guy, too.
I'm sad we haven't seen a single fall of the hammer.
We'll get there.
All right. Let's take this thing?
Yeah.
All right. I don't think our colors are open.
It's possible they're not.
Considering how much good blue and black there is...
The black hasn't been, like, fun. The blue's been pretty good. The black's been, like, it's been okay.
I guess.
I don't know. Yeah, sure.
All right, I guess we'll take the God Favored General now. I don't like this guy very much.
No, because he's terrible.
Like, that's a lot of mana to pay just for 3/1s with no, like, there's no Trumpet Blast effects.
Lightning Felix just subscribed.
What a great name. I'm taking Fearsome Temper instead.
Lightning Felix, thank you for subscribing. I'm going to get my bag now.
Lightning Felix, thank you for subscribing. Welcome to the runners.
Remember, guys, if you can't subscribe, you should absolutely follow the channel. Yeah. I would really appreciate it if everybody followed the channel.
That shouldn't be here.
Because maybe in a little bit, I will give away another copy of Big Giant Circle's album. But only to people who are following our channel.
I guess we're just taking Mono Mortal's Ardor. Like...
Sure.
We're not in the right colors. I guess we should get some stuff in our color in the third pack.
We'll be fine. We just gotta get 2 more Lego Pegasus. Loyal Pegasus.
It's too late for blue.
Aha. There we go. Sun Guide, that's nice. Yeah, we're not switching now. Badger, badger, badger. Oh,
oh, I'm sorry.
Badger, badger, badger. This, I don't care. Yeah, badger got there.
Get out of our deck.
You can so cut that Dream Finder. I don't think we're going to play that in a million years.
Forcing all the Boros. Look, we got 18 playables.
You can probably cut two of those mortals into our door.
Mortal Darder.
Yeah, probably.
Ooh, dang it. Dang it. I need a Faragax Giant, I guess.
Yep.
Is Guild worth anything?
I don't think so.
I don't really see it being worth... Oh, not that one. This one. I don't see it being worth anything, but I am curious.
We're not splashing for Guild. Badger.
Nope. Guild ain't worth F.
Yeah, giant. Pegasus, 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 Pegasus. Damn it. Ugh. What is going on? This isn't even our fault anymore. These packs are just terrible for
taking
us.
Taking this Temple of... Actually, Bile Blight is actually worth something.
Yeah. I don't know if it's worth a lot, but it's worth probably, like, maybe a ticket.
It's worth one whole ticket.
Yeah. Yeah, that's not bad for an uncommon.
Let's take the Temple.
Do we just want another giant?
We could splash our Charging Badger.
Yeah, that's not going to happen. Do we not just want to take another giant?
I guess.
Or something. Something that will actually play.
I agree with you, Wolfgang Cloud. This deck seems meh. You can't splash blue. Temple for Badger. All right, I'll take this giant. Ah, this guy's good.
Yep.
Though we still could take a second Excoriate.
I think I'd rather just another guy. We're only 13 guys right now. Damn it. That's the same thing. No, take another guy. Just one more.
Hey.
Hey.
Aw.
Ooh.
That's really good. This card is a beating.
Yeah?
I think we gotta take this. This card is horrific. Splash Chromanticore. We don't even have one. So many Helix. This is a Swiss. Eldrazi Outlaw. This is definitely a Swiss. We would not be seeing Retraction Helixes this late.
Are there 8/4s versus of these... Events?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I told you I won one the other day. And I lost two others, but I won one.
All right, Pinnacle.
Pinnacle's so good. Who needs a ban? Oh, yeah. Good point. Boop.
Do your jobs, mods.
Jobs, mods. Mods,
it's
jobs.
Right there.
What is their job? I guess banning spam is
banning
pretty...
Banning spam is right up there.
That's the high one.
If you want to post a link in this channel, that is fine. Just do so with a description.
And have it not be porn.
And yeah, but as long as it's not porn, then you're good to go.
I had someone play two of these main deck against me.
Nice.
Kept them alive for two turns, and then I killed them.
All right, well, we take it for some timber.
We're not getting whimsical. Ooh! I want to try this.
All right.
Let's run this. This thing looks fun. How many creatures do we have? 15? Let's do this.
I mean, that's our deck right now, so.
Yep, here's the deck. Dear Dr. James, sorry, I was moderating Lurecraft.
You're fine.
Bah. Alright. What the fuck?
Foil Mind Reaver, take it.
You get an elk?
Yeah.
Or a third fairy?
We're not going to play another giant.
No.
We're not playing any of these cards over the cards we have, so.
We only got two Loyal Pegasus.
I know.
I'm so bummed.
I was hoping for at least three. I wanted six. Six didn't seem like what it was outside the realm of.
Yeah. Oh, wait.
Nope.
That's not making noise. Don't know why.
Boo. All these cards are terrible. Well, not.
They're not. This is really good.
Not terrible. Terrible for us. When I say terrible, I mean for us. Badger, 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 badger.
could have three mind reavers.
Wow. All right.
Still, like, kind of trying to run him just with the loyal Pegasus beats.
Sure.
It'd be kind of fun.
I'm okay with running two of these.
Oh, you're wearing the wrong headphones. That's why the music came through for them.
Oh. Oh, yeah. Why did you unplug the splitter?
Because it takes down the volume a lot. It pisses me off.
Just turn the headphones up. Elk. Sure. Well, it's a deck. Seems fine. It's not amazing, but it's fine.
This deck could use about three ordeals. Yes, yes, it could.
There aren't any in this format. Yeah, all right.
Yeah, it needs more ordeals. All right. Add deck. Or add land. Slam submit. Yep.
That's actually probably. No. 9-8. Because we want to try and hit Pegasus on one if we can.
Yeah. We also have... We do have three...
We got Fated Conflagration.
Three double reds and a triple red.
Yeah. I think 9-8's fine. We don't need the... Yeah. I think that's fine.
Submit.
Wait. Boop. There we go. I can't believe we didn't get a single fall of the hammer. Someone must have just been snapping those up. We didn't take the scry land.
See you, ball. What?
Paul wants
oh, two. It's down on the hat rack. Or coat rack.
Does it not say it's triple born of the gods? It does. How many heroic triggers do we have? One. Two. Two.
Well, then three, four. The,
oh, yeah. Three, four.
Yeah.
So it's not amazing. But we're running this guy. So this is better. It's not the best Triple Born of the Gods deck I've ever drafted. It's not a thing that people typically say. You guys excited for the Pro Tour this weekend? What is this? What?
The Pro Tour needs to come back to a land of...
That's amazing.
North America, so I can watch it at a normal time.
I like that they have the picture of dogs playing poker on the wall.
On the wall, yeah.
Also, apparently Mirari's Wake is just... not Mirari's Wake. Mirari is just sitting in a cabinet.
What's on the other side?
Is that meant to be Urza's head?
I don't know.
I can't tell what that is over there. It looks like... Oh, it's... Look, it's...
All right.
It's a nickel bolus head.
Two things. Somebody subscribed.
Stuffed and mounted. What? Who subscribed?
Where did
it go?
Three. Thank you for subscribing, three. Because that's the only part of your name I can pronounce.
Escherichia.
Yeah.
Escherichia, three.
Woo!
Thank you for subscribing. Welcome to the Runners. Good to have you here.
Thank you for being the sixth subscriber of the day. Uh-oh, I lost my ring. No, they're just...
Who's the golem? That's Karn.
Yeah.
Karn, silver golem.
And, because we didn't mention it before because we got right into things, we have a sponsor for our drafts.
Derp.
Card Kingdom. We didn't talk about yet. But we should talk about Card Kingdom. I placed an order with Card Kingdom last night. And I told them that Loading Ready Run sent me, do not send me a button, please. Because I won't take buttons away from you guys. But you might as well get our name in there, right? Because why not? So everybody head over to cardkingdom.com and look at their very easy-to-use website.
I wanted to show you, I retweeted something that someone sent the other day. This was on February 17th. Card Kingdom shipping never fails to amaze me. Ordered Wednesday night, delivered in Australia Monday morning.
That's impressive. I won't even get my package that quickly.
No, that beats the crap out of anything we get. Yeah. That's astonishing.
Yeah. But absolutely go check out Card Kingdom. And when you are done your order, which you absolutely should do, let them know that Loading Ready Run sent you. Write that out. Loading Ready Run sent me, button please. And you will get this cycles? Yes, thank you. That's exactly the word.
This season's hot button.
This season's hot button, which is right there. Get Garried.
Get Garried.
Only available if you make a purchase through cardkingdom.com. Limited supplies. The last button went really quick, so get on this one quickly. Today's storm count is... Wait, what?
That's Cypher 48 has just subscribed. Cypher 48, thank you for subscribing. Welcome.
Woo! Thank you for subscribing. When we get to 10 subscribers on the day, I will give away an album of the musics.
You put the bag on your head while people are sub during your stream, too?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah. I do. Ugh.
How many Garys have you guys collected? I don't know.
I need a foil Gary. Do you have a foil Gary?
I don't know.
Gary's getting in the cube. He's getting in the popper cube. I need a foil Gary now.
We might have traded. It's possible that people, that the bots have actually bought a couple.
No. I mean a
real... No, I know. I just mean...
Yeah.
I want to see how many we have.
Oh. Yeah, they might all be gone.
Yeah,
it's a like card that's actually played in standard.
In standard, yeah. It looks like the... Yeah. Looks like the bots have taken them all. Choking on peanut shells.
Yes, this is our fourth button. The pre-orders for the sleeves and playmats are going quite well. Thank you for bringing them up. You guys should go check out.
Oh, yeah.
If you go to loadingreadyrun.com/store... You can check out our fantastic new sleeves and playmats. So they're up for pre-order. I think they've been up for two weeks now?
I think so.
Or has it been a week? No, it's been 2 weeks. Yeah, absolutely it's been 2 weeks. So I think a couple more weeks and we will be going ahead and getting these things printed up and shipped out to you guys. So get your orders in now.
Well, I have requested, I don't know if they're being made yet, but I have requested an order, so.
Sweet.
Because we don't want to keep people waiting too long.
You have an in-real-life foil, Gary. Well, dang yo. Do you mind dropping it off? You have already ordered all the things. That's cool. There was a big post on Reddit about them. That was actually kind of cool.
I saw that. That was really neat, because we didn't make that post. I was like, oh crap, that's us. Someone just tweeted, where do I, oh, I can't, unless I'm logged in, I can't see the,
Theoretically, you could search for, I don't even know.
Is that accurate?
Nope. Apparently not.
Let's try that. No, wait, no, I know what it is. Yeah, there we go. Dupe. Doop.
Nice.
Like Demir. Get Gearied. Oh, and a Theros. Yeah. Or, Born of the Gods.
Born of the Gods.
Thingy. Sweet. What? Oh, yes. Marvel as Graham fails to log into Twitter. We're waiting for the draft of fire.
Chroniclerk, just email me.
Chroniclerk?
And I will let you know what you can do to get us cards if you'd like to.
Ooh, sweet. I can't remember what I was saying. Thank you, Taste Arsenic. That plain mat makes me so hard.
Your theory is that Garrick isn't going to get a card in M15?
No. That's not what I said. My theory is Garrick is not the green planeswalker.
Oh, okay.
Because he, in both the key art and those vinyl figures, he's not shown with color, and Nissa is another vinyl figure that is shown as being green. I think Nissa is the green planeswalker for M15, and Garrick is in the set.
Yeah,
just,
I see that.
I don't know, green black. Like, I think it'll be a new Garrick, something to do with the Veil Curse of Malarkey. Yeah. This is also a straight mulligan.
Yes. That's not better, but I mean, it's got two lands, so go.
It's definitely better. It's not good, but it's definitely better.
Yeah, Lurkon is May 10th. Yay, more land. Okay, no more land. I think we can almost cast everything in our deck now.
We can't even cast two things in our hand. Now we can. Well, we can cast one thing in our hand. Haha. Eat it. Trade you damage. And next turn we get to get the Cyclops down there. Oh! They make each other able to block.
Yeah.
That's cute. I'm just going to offer this trade.
But you could exile it.
I could exile this one.
Yeah. And then it can't block.
Oh, yeah. I guess I could. But that's the whole turn, and that's wasting a hard removal spell on a Fellhide Brawler.
But for all we know, that's all he has.
He's just got a deck full of Fellhide Brawlers. Drarch. No, the hotel is closer to the
airport.
Yeah. But you can get from where the Clipper goes to the airport fairly easily. At least I hope so, because we have to do that.
There is. Well, we'd probably drive. Dominated! That card is bonkers. We're dead.
We should leave it as a 5-5. Take a hit from it and then excoriate? Yeah, all right. Yes, we pay your tribute. Speaking of which, offer you a trade. Yeah, I didn't think so. You're afraid. He's afraid. What about you? Are you gonna tribute me? Huh? What you gonna do? By the way, this card's really good.
It's very, very good.
In case that was ever unclear. Henge Guardian. Fellhide Baller. Navarin, what is Lurkon?
Admiral Mamo just posted a link.
Oh, well,
just
then.
A little up chat. LoadingReadyRun.com/info/LRRCon. You can hear all about it.
Well, all about everything that we know so far.
Yep.
There's more coming. Somebody emailed me and was like, what magic formats? Because I want to prepare decks. I was like, Commander and Draft, I would imagine.
Yep, pretty much.
Oh, that guy's big. Still trades for each of these guys, though. Yeah, jam on in. Yeah, come on. Go for it. Why not? Two drop. What was that? Oh, I mean, we could actually just... Well, then we could just kill it.
And scry two.
Yeah.
Do it.
I mean, oh wait, no, this guy's a 3/3. This does not trade.
No.
All right, so let's see if he wants to trade Marsh Mist Titan for the Cyclops. Draft Mander? I don't even know what that is.
Draft a commander deck?
Oh, wait, we had him dead. We had him dead. We had him dead.
How did we have him dead?
He's at 8. Did we have 8 on the table? Like, just kill this thing and then attack, and then we win.
Oh, yeah.
That was dumb. Oh, well. Sure. Lightning Volley, no. Ghostblade, sure. Loading Ready Run Magic the Gathering for sick plays like that.
And then this.
Oh, whatever. Yeah. Have that. Don't care. So he has to block with the Shrike Harpy here or he's dead.
Correct.
Rawr!
No, there will probably not be. I mean, basically bring whatever decks you want.
Yeah, if you like Modern and have a Modern deck, bring it, and I'm sure someone else will, and you guys can play.
Like, we will endeavor to organize some drafts and Commander things, but then it's up to you guys to figure out what else you want to do. So. Nice.
Awkward. Target creature can't block this creature this turn. Okay.
So cast it.
Cast it, make the, I guess, the sun guide.
Yeah,
can't. Not able to block.
Yeah.
Yeah. That lets him gain life. Well, no, because we're going to kill it if he attacks with it, so. Ha-ha. Should have won this game turns ago. Can't wear hats. You've got him dead. I think you're a little behind us. We definitely did have him dead. And then we threw it away.
All right, so.
I think we should just kill this thing. It keeps getting in.
Yeah, that's fine. But we can do the can't block thing, right?
I don't care if you. Oh, yeah, right.
Then we would have. Yeah.
Well, I assume you had a plan. Look, I'm obviously tired today. Just throwing this game away. Oh, Necrobite. Great. Great.
Oh, yeah. I guess it's, yeah.
Yeah. Great. Good job, Graham.
Well,
now we can kill this. You know who's awesome right now is me.
Yeah, we don't lose our guy. Yeah, I didn't think so.
Wait, what? Oh, because right.
Because it's double strike.
Right. All right. Play this thing. Kill this thing.
It's one card. There. Well, that was a roundabout way of getting there, but hey, we got it. Now what?
This week on Games We Don't Deserve to Win, because Graham keeps making horrible, horrible mistakes. All right, let's try and not suck so bad this game. I don't think we have anything we want to...
No, we okay. really don't.
All right. One more time. I agree. Everyone who is saying how bad that was is completely correct.
Kapol, I don't actually... I have no idea how ticket sales for Lurkon are doing. That is not actually something we are in charge of. Somebody else is organizing that, and we haven't asked yet.
That's probably the worst I've played in a while. I don't think we can keep this.
No, we can't.
I mean, we played this on 3 and then like put this on it. That's pretty cool, but...
Well, we need to draw a mountain to do
yeah, exactly, so... All right. Sweet. I mean, it's going to be a couple turns, but keeping it.
The PayPal link says Penny Arcade because Penny Arcade deals with all of our merchandise. They actually are the ones who ship it all out. That is why it says Penny Arcade. You absolutely do need to buy a ticket to Lurkon Lego Buttocks. I would prefer, I mean, in the long run, I'd much prefer Theros block, but triple BNG a couple times when the format's just starting getting off the ground is absolutely fun to do.
Obviously, it was never designed to be drafted as triple BNG, but I think it's fun. It's a chance to see more of the new cards.
Yeah.
Wow, what's happening here? Don't know why I played that land specifically, but here we are. Okay, I'll take it. Nope, Omnicrat, they still handle our merchandise. There's no reason for that to happen.
That's fine.
Give them the I'll do the same thing last time. Yep. I pay your tribute. We attack with this guy and use this. We can trade for that, but I don't think that matters. So.
I think you just play out the giant. Let him attack. The triple dragon's maze was weird.
Graham, if I order now, when are playmats likely to be sent? Not for a couple weeks. Or probably a little more than a couple weeks. They need to be made and then shipped to Seattle and then sent to you. So, ooh, opponent does not want to take the 5. Sadly, we lose the 4 power on this guy, but whatever. Probably could have attacked with him. Like, likely our opponent wouldn't have blocked. But.
I like getting the 5-5 out.
Hey, Zaro. Whoa. Yeah, right. Not bestowing it. That's bold. And not attacking.
And not either. Attacking. Interesting.
So, Necrobite? Necrobite? Like, almost assuredly Necrobite?
Yeah.
Alright. I'm just gonna Fearsome Temper on... I don't know, the Pegasus?
I guess, yeah.
Pass turn?
Yep.
Hey, Voidhawk42 has just subscribed. Voidhawk42, thank you for subscribing. Welcome.
Huzzah!
Welcome to the runners.
Just a quick rundown, guys. If you subscribe, you get the following. A, you get me in a bag.
You get James in the bag.
You get Graham saying stuff.
Yeah.
And then for actually subscribing, you're supporting us, which we really appreciate.
Ooh, like sick.
The support you guys have given us over the last 2 months has been incredible.
Mm-hmm.
But you get subscriber-only emotes, which you can see being used in the chat by our current subscribers.
And you can use those on any Twitch
chat channel,
that you go to.
Which is pretty sweet.
Wow.
You can have mobile updates, like directly to your phone. Twitch will be like, hey, Loading Ready Run just went live. You should go watch them.
Those are opt-in.
Opt-in. Sick. That's sweet.
I'm going to exile this.
Do what?
I'm going to exile this, though.
Yeah. And then, on top of that, you also get an entry into our monthly, right now, maybe it'll turn into more than just monthly, subscriber giveaways.
Yeah, regenerate from that.
So,
I'm going to attack with everyone. He probably still has the Necrobite, but at least I can...
Yeah, go for it.
Whatever. I don't... Just die.
There are all the emotes...
You get that Necrobite.
And there will be more. And if you guys have suggestions for any, there's still a thread in the forums.
Should I just use this now to gain life? Gain 6 life? Or just let this happen? Like, it's going to be the Necrobite, right?
I would assume so, yeah.
Eh, whatever. We can do it in response if we really want. Yeah, there it is. So, I don't know. What do you think? Just gain 6? Or save the trick?
I could see saving the trick. I mean, it lets us get in for... I mean, it could get in for that extra 1 point of damage later on, which could be useful. I mean, he's in a pretty...
Yeah.
He's not in a great spot.
We'll save it.
I think we save it because, yeah, that extra point could come into... All
right.
No, Lego Buttocks, your sword does not entitle you to anything. If anything, you should be paying us more money. You can just give me a dollar next time you see me. Pwah. So that's 8 subs on the day, guys. 2 more and I will give away a copy of Big Giant Circle's latest album.
Sweet.
To a random follower of the channel.
You suck.
So make sure that you follow the channel, guys. If you're not following the channel, follow the channel and you'll have a chance to win an album.
Yeah, I was hoping he'd attack with those guys.
A very good album. Alright, so we're taking 7.
Yeah, but that's fine, because... Oh!
Oh, dear
That's
God.
Even better. So this just kills this thing.
And then
we get in for 8, 9. Oh. Or... Can't block this creature, that doesn't work. Make him trade.
Like, don't you just...
No, we just kill this. It makes this thing smaller. We still take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We still take lethal next turn if we don't play a creature, though. Although, it was 5 damage to target, you know, creature or planeswalker. So we can... kill a thing, dome him for 3. Take him to 7. No, that doesn't work. Yeah, this doesn't hit players.
No.
Oh, right, lifelink.
Yep.
That's true. Yeah, all right. So we just, we kill that, swing out.
Gain 5.
Gain 5.
And then...
Oh, okay, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah, we're sweet. All right. You're both poopy.
The Sun Chaser's an extra 1 point of damage in the air next turn. I mean, he's dead next turn.
Yeah, but we have Pinnacle of Rage, so
yeah.
I'm just going to bottom both of these.
Oh!
What?
Frank's Arrowt.
What? Frank Serrot? Frank Serrot? Frank Serrot, thank you for subscribing!
Woo!
Welcome to the Runners.
9 subscribers on the day, guys. Thank you so much. That's super awesome. Probably between this round, we'll give away that album. Dear God, blowout. He's at 1, we're at 11, we win.
What now?
I think that's how that works.
What now?
That's how this game should work.
Face of Rage. Rawr.
If you get to 11 and they get to 1. I like how Spot has become the new... Ooh, don't care.
Yeah, I don't know why we did... the other day I was like, give the subscriber Spot the dog. Why not? It's the welcome thing. What's only Twick? Why are we main decking Sun Chaser? Well,
because
Loyal Pegasus mostly. Yeah. Also, the rest of our cards are not astounding, so
also that card is super good. True story.
Can you do 8 to us right here? Okay.
He's just trying to save his ass here.
Cool story.
So now just cast that. Oh, do it! Do it! Absolutely do it right now. Dominated. Yes, very slow. English, not language first. All right. Ping him. Salty. Well, at least he said good luck. All right, just ping him. Let's move on with our lives. Yes, we killed him with a Loyal Pegasus.
Reveal hand.
Reveal, reveal, reveal.
I so outdrew you.
That is how this game works. All right, guys, let's give away an album. Follow the channel right now if you want to have a chance to win this album, because if we draw a random name and you aren't following us, then I'm not going to give you this super awesome album.
So it's just any follower?
Any follower is eligible to win this album. Right. So I'm going to give you guys a couple minutes. I'm going to give you 1 minute, and I'm going to get Graham to...
Oh, yeah, so I got to go to...
So go to the dashboard.
Dashboard.
Just show chat.
Oh. Boop.
And then there should be a little present button down there now.
Oh, there is. Look, it's a gift.
And then...
Ah, there it is. That's the plugin I'm used to seeing.
Yep.
Neat.
So, I'm going to give them a couple minutes, and then you need to make sure you hit the update. Hit it right now, actually, because obviously we have more than... That's weird. How many people are...
We have more people watching than that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, with 700 people. Is there only that? That's... What the hell?
Explain more about the album.
Is that only how many people are in chat?
I have no idea.
Anyways, so we are going to give away the music of Big Giant Circles. It is a friend of ours named Jimmy Hinson. Super awesome guy. He's done music for... Like, so much stuff. He's done music for Mass Effect. He's done music for mobile games such as Pocket Minds and the newest game, Threes. You should definitely check out that game. Super fun puzzle game. Couple years ago, he released an album titled Imposter Nostalgia. It is his
so good.
Modern day
sort of chiptune album, and this is his follow-up album, and it's so much better. Like, I loved Imposter Nostalgia, and it was such a fantastic album, but this one is just above and beyond anything else, and it's really good, and I listened to it way too much, and if you watch my stream, or if you have been watching my stream for the last couple weeks, I play it basically every week. So, yeah, you should absolutely follow the channel for a chance to win this album. I might give out another copy tonight. I have a few to give away. But for now, we'll just start with the one. So let's... Unless this app is just...
Oh, no, I see. It's people who have actually talked. How do you do it to just be everyone in chat? There we go. Wait, no.
Ah, there we go.
Ah.
That makes way more sense.
Got there. All right.
All right, guys. We're going to roll the dice.
Do, 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 do,
bump, boom.
Deej Ford.
Congratulations, Deej Ford. You have won.
No, it's okay. We got everyone.
We got it working.
We drew from everyone, not just the people talking. Yeah. Don't worry.
You're good.
Duskshine, I do remember that. How could I ever forget? Deej Ford, you win.
Deej Ford, congratulations.
You can all stop talking. They will have heard that by now.
All right, let's wait. Oh, there he is. So then you can see, yeah. So mm-hmm. He says something and it pulls it out, which is real nice.
So what do we...
So now go write message. And... Whoa, what the... All right.
Admiral Mamo, who wants to see Twitch plays Magic Online?
That URL and the third code down.
So that URL.
Yeah. So go to that URL, type in that third.
Wait, I do or it'll tell him?
Tell him to.
Okay. Talk to internet. Probably
do that. Internet. So that is how our giveaways are going to work from now on. Congratulations to Deej Ford on the first win of the evening. I might give away one more later tonight. I think I have like 8 to give away, so I want to space them out.
So you said the third one down?
Yeah. Third one down.
Okay.
Cool.
Boop.
All right. So Deej Ford, just check your Twitch messages and you should be good to go.
Deej Ford. Should we do a commercial break?
We should do a commercial break. I'm going to do a bathroom break.
So. Even better. All right, we're going to run a quick ad and we'll be right back before the next round. Later. Yay, we're back. Or I'm back. James is still making a bathroom child. How are you? No. I don't care about Naked Riley. Go away. Allo Pugalo. Wait, what? I'm banned, but the text is still there. That's odd. Typically, banning also deletes the... There we go. Weird. Had to do it on the other monitor. Very strange. Wow. So much with the porn spam. Hey, Zara. Oh, 1 second. Hey everyone, we have a visitor. She's just popping by to say hello. And there is a doge.
It's that camera.
Oh, God. Ah. Giant Doge.
Hey, Buster.
Buster's so confused.
Hey, you can bring him around here. Maya's in the chat.
Maya! What you talking about?
Sniff, sniff. We're playing Magic.
Of course you are.
Well, we're in between rounds right now. That's what we do on Thursdays. Hey, Snorts. How's it going?
It's like, what is this?
He looks very confused.
Aw. Little guy. Where's my stuff?
Lego Buttock says,
Buster!
Boof!
Why you boof at James? You know who James is.
What'd you do here?
I came to get my stuff.
Yeah, it's in the other room up on the shelf. I found a bunch of stuff the other day that was labeled with, like, this is Ashes, she will come pick it up.
Oh.
And I was that's clearly a lie.
Clearly. Bye, Internet.
Goodbye, Ash. And that was Dog. Dogterlude. Boof snarf. Unknown gamer is correct. Doggy's name is Buster. Oh, I can tell her to do that, Maya, if you want, if she has space, or if she can carry it. You also left a couple lobsters here, Maya, and another thing of Lego. You have a bunch of shit lying around over here. Come get your stuff, gosh. One sec. All right, apparently the B-Wing's already at James's house, so have fun getting that one back, Maya. Yes, everyone check out megacynics.com. That's Ash's webcomic. It's linked in the chat already. Go to the next round. Go to the next round. What? No, the audio's back. I turned it. No, I assume you're. Yeah, I assume you're behind. Wow, that was a while. Oh well. Big delay today. Has anyone ever explained how the moon base is orbiting a submoon? Yes, I can show you that. We did it. There's a diagram of it at the beginning of our podcast.
For what?
How the moon base is orbiting and underground.
Oh, yeah.
If you look at the beginning of the Lurecast, there's a diagram. There we go.
It's orbiting underground.
Let's try that again. So there's the supermoon, and then the submoon within the Earth's crust. And the moon base is, as you can see, underground and orbiting. It's underground orbiting moon base from deep within the Earth's... chasmous innards. Yeah.
But yeah, no, that B-Wing looks super nice in my house, Maya. You should come over and check it out sometime.
You should take Maya's other shit home with you.
I should. It's just all my shit now. Now I just need to make one in Minecraft? Yeah.
You could do that.
An orbiting underground moon base in Minecraft?
Yeah, like we could hollow out a huge subterranean area.
Yeah.
And then make a moon in the middle of it.
Yeah. I don't know how you would...
And then make a floating... Because you can make stuff float.
Yeah, you can make it float. I don't know if you could... I wonder if you could make it actually move.
Moving, no.
Not
with vanilla Minecraft, anyway. You'd need an awful lot of redstone, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, so, I stole all your stuff, Maya.
So I was looking into the spectator mode that just got released.
For what?
For Minecraft.
Yeah.
It looks really sweet. If we do another group Minecraft
stream. Me and Alex were actually talking about doing that the other day.
Yeah.
Where if we set it up so that the spectator was here, mm-hmm. streaming, but also kind of hosting it, but not playing, they would have access to everybody and could just...
I think if we do that again, that's something I'd rather do that than...
Yeah, than actually before. Somebody... Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I think that would work really well.
Yeah, I'd like to do... I know that our next, like, monthly group stream was not going to be Minecraft, but maybe some other time we could do that with a couple people anyway, because that was... A, it was a lot of fun, and B, we got really good feedback. Like, people really
liked it. Yeah, people liked it, yeah. All right.
Why is this Dusk Shine. So, Graham, do you have any plans for more Girls' Generation dancing this year? My friend giggled her ass off at the videos from Desert Bus 7 and thinks you should dance to I've Got a Boy this coming Desert Bus. The problem with I've Got a Boy is it's very complex hip-hop moves. There's a lot to it. Granted, I looked into it. I'm not going to lie. I looked at I Got a Boy, but it is... There's a lot going on in that video. It also looks like that video, I don't know, it looks like Asian fashion just exploded everywhere.
Legal research.
Like, this is colorful as hell.
What is going on?
Have you not seen this?
No, I tried to steer clear of Drill's Generation.
That's fair.
I can't do it. Maybe put the splitter back. What is, dear? It's so pink.
Not all their stuff is, but this is.
Oh, that was kind of cool.
Yeah, they use a lot of bullet time for no good reason.
Yeah.
The sets in K-pop are effing ridiculous.
Pretty sure most
Korean music video budget just goes to insane sets. It's like, okay, I could do that. It just gets more complex as you go. Also, their choreography is all designed to maximize the fact that there's friggin' 9 of them.
It is a Korean S Club 7.
Except there's 9 of them.
Yeah.
S Club 9.
S Club 7's better than this, though.
That's fair. You ready for the drop? Hey, you stop. Let me put it down another
way. I was not expecting that.
This song's all over the place. So the demo for this song was done by a different artist. And it almost sounds like reggae music.
Okay.
And it's being sung, I discovered after the fact, by like the blondest, whitest California girl. Basically just doing what Snow does and just like affecting a really thick accent. Also do Pop and Lock a lot better than I can, which is surprising.
This is surprisingly long for this type of song. 5 minutes?
Oh, their videos are always long because they have like
intros
and outros.
Okay.
Frick, you should see the video for The Boys. The video, the intro is like 2 minutes and has nothing to do with the rest of the song. It's ridiculous. Though it did result in a pretty fantastic animated GIF.
Huh.
All right, now.
Is there another drop?
No, now it just changes in tone completely.
What the hell? This is weird. It's like three different songs in this song.
Yeah, they actually skip this part when they're doing it live because it's too weird.
Don't stop. Let's bring it back to 140. What the fuck?
Gnert says, Graham, have you heard of AKB48? And if so, have you heard of AKB00048? No. Wait. Hang on. I'm not gonna play a whole video. Because that would drive everyone insane. But you need to see this, James. This is ridiculous. Alright, so this is I don't know what the context for this was, but it was Girls' Generation and AKB48. Performing at the same event. Hang on.
Excuse me.
Okay, so here's the end of Girls' Generation song. That's Girls' Generation.
What the fuck?
This is one group.
What? Why is there so many of them?
Because they're called AKB48 because there's 48 of them.
Why is there... What? That seems excessive.
That's too many people. That's way too many people.
Nine people is too many people. That's bigger than the majority of bands out there. That's ridiculous.
It's 48 people.
Like, I remember when I thought S Club 7 was insane. There's seven of them. 48? Like, honestly, like, if you removed half of them, they would sound exactly the same, right?
Right.
If you remove three quarters of them, they would probably sound the same.
There's 48 of them.
That's ridiculous. Is there like a lead person?
In AKB48? Like, I don't think so.
Like,
there's barely a lead in
Girls'
in Girls' Generation. There's only nine of them.
That's impressive.
I know Slipknot has nine people, but like aren't like five of them drummers?
Yeah, probably. Yeah, I was just going to say, 40 is two choirs.
Two choirs.
Yeah.
They split them up into squads. No, AKB is from Japan. That's true. AKB48 did the Sugar Rush theme from Wreck-It Ralph. Or some of them did. 48 is like 44 too many. Yeah. It's not a band, it's a Girl Scout division.
Oh my god.
Oh, that's great. 48 people is as many as four dozens, and that's just too many. No.
S Club isn't too many.
We thought it was too many.
Back in the day, that was a lot of people for like one band.
Yeah. I mean, when you look, of course, at Ain't No Party Like an S Club Party, they ran out of stuff for them to do.
Yeah.
Two of the people in that song were doing their thing.
Yeah.
In the roll call, they call out each one of them and it's like, someone's doing this, someone's doing this. Two of them are doing their thing. It's like, you have too many people if you can't think of individual things for them all to do. In fact, a third one who wasn't even one of the ones doing their thing was just cheering for more.
Somebody just, Carnassus says, on the game, three guys in round one of that draft.
Oh, God, really?
Yeah, there he is, too. Yeah, that's not updated.
Carnassus, play faster.
Play fast.
I don't want to watch this GIF. Why did you post that GIF? Yep. There's me dancing. Merry Christmas.
Ska bands do tend to have a lot of people, but they are all doing something. They're not all just singing the same song.
I like...
You have a, like... A,
you've seen the you've seen the Key of Awesome video for the Mumford Band?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's just like, we found everyone who was hanging around, and we gave this guy a washboard and this person a harmonica, and we put them in a vest, and now they're up on stage. That's a good point, actually. At least in a ska band... Or, and in Slipknot, at least they're actually doing something.
Yeah, just like 48 people singing the same song is like, at least in that format, like it, they all ran out on stage and were dancing around and like trying to be the pop band, and it's just like, what? I like how we have the chat going on every monitor.
Yeah, I'll close that one. 48 AKB 48 is almost 7 S Club 7s. Well, you know, considering S Club 7 went through that time portal in that video, and which was never resolved, you know, maybe they could duplicate themselves over and over again. Yeah. Can't believe they had a TV show. It's a guy in Slipknot who just wanders around on stage with a baseball bat.
That's an important role.
They're starting their own army. I would probably follow that army into battle. Mostly because I wouldn't want to be on the other side of that army.
Yeah.
I wouldn't know what to do. 48 Japanese girls running at you. I'd be like, I'm out. Of course I know that video, Lego Buttocks. We were totally into S Club back in the day.
That video is awesome. I was posting about it on Facebook a couple days ago. That video is amazing.
There is no party like an S Club party. It's provable.
I was trying to convince Ashley to make our song, the song we danced to, an S Club song, like our first dance, to be To Become One. She isn't buying. I still.
What about Don't Stop?
That's too fast. Like our first dance, like, right? But
AKB 0048 is an anime about that band in the future fighting against the Fun Police.
What? Oh my god.
I need to see this now. Hang on. Is there like a intro, like the opening titles? Dear Lord. I don't know what they're saying. I hope it's not rude.
Oh yeah, To Become One is Spice Girls. What's the... okay, I didn't mean Spice Girls. What song did I mean by S Club? I
gotta figure That's not 48. That's an awful lot of them, though. I assume this is a slightly reduced cast. I mean, I'm only counting, like, a dozen. Endless Tears! A tiny octopus fruit. Hearts, rabbit ears. High socks and higher skirts. There needs to be a group shot at the end of this thing. No? It's just the two of them? Yeah, there's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There's only 9 of them. This could be a girls' generation show. That's your whole AKB48 is your whole brand. That's your whole dang thing. Looks like a logical extension of that Daft Punk video. Oh, I love Interstellar. If you have to hand animate them, there can't be 48 of them. That's fair. 2 in a Million.
That's the song.
Thank you, Navarin, who says, oh god, why do I know that?
Yeah, it is 2 in a Million.
I wish Plummeting Sloth was right. The 48 comes in when they form a massive schoolgirl fusion robot. It's still not as dumb of a. That's not the dumbest looking opening theme to an anime I've seen. So. Please, we didn't lose viewers through that. Morning Musume currently has 10 members, but they've got like a bajillion other members, don't they? Because they have like splinter groups and people like graduate from that band when they get too old and then they form their other groups. It's a mess. They pop open like Russian dolls. Did a quick count of current members. 48 people is half the size of the London Symphony Orchestra.
Wow.
Love it. It's not J-pop, Rakdos the Defiler. Well, half of it was J-pop. The other half was K-pop. Racist. I'm sorry. All 48 of them combined into one when the Thundercats theme music is sung.
Yeah, this round is going to time.
Apparently, Nirvana. Apparently.
I blame Carnassus.
Almost wish I double queued now. Almost.
Almost.
Patty cakes, we're much more in democracy mode. Actually, we're almost in. I was gonna say dictatorship, but there's two of us, so more of a monarchy.
Yeah.
An oligarchy, actually. James and I are the oligarchs in this case. We run this.
I think there's about as many people in the Wu-Tang Clan.
That's a great trivia question, by the way. Name all the members of the Wu-Tang Clan. That's a tough one. There's a couple people that you always forget about when you're asked to list everyone in Wu-Tang. And there's usually one person that you think is in the Wu-Tang Clan, but was not. So, you know, if you're ever in pub trivia, brush up on that one. A diumvirate.
We don't have time for a double Q right now.
I wouldn't say that we're elected. Maybe if we scrub out of next round, like, or scrub out or win next round, like, super fast, maybe we'll do a single elimination.
What does a threes cosplay entail? I'll make you a big old rectangle with the number 6 on it? Why do I have to be number 6? I want to be number 24. So, huh. MTG pub trivia night? That'd be kind
of
cool.
I totally meant to have another piece of MTG trivia for you in the last tap, but I forgot.
Oh, yeah.
Name all the members of AKB48. Yeah, right. You know how long it took me to be able to tell the Girls' Generation apart?
No, screw you,
Lego Bucks. The trick there being that they look different in every single video. That's why it's challenging, not...
Not the other not, racist reason.
Not the racist reason.
All right. We are now over time. How is that even a thing? Why is this 50 minutes and 50 seconds?
If they ran their sideboards to time. See? Thank you, Maya. It's really difficult. Naxo chills. Yes, I can tell Girls' Generation apart.
One could ask why you worked so hard at that.
RZA, Method Man, Raekwon, Ghostface, Killa, Inspect a Deck, Master Killa, ODB, Jizza, and U-God. I think that's them, Dostro. The trick, though, is everyone's going through and listing, and they're like, RZA, Jizza, Ghostface, Killa, Method Man, Red Man, this thing, and you're like, ah, no! No! Red Man wasn't in Wu-Tang. It's just in your head, Method Man and Red Man are a combined unit, but Red Man was not in the Wu-Tang. Evil Smurf, yeah, we won, but it's a Swiss, so. But we also won. Because we outdrew our opponent with luck or something. Our opponent got salty at the end there. We had two ways to kill him in hand. SNSD is Girls' Generation. The band is called Girls' Generation, which in Korea, they have a different name, which the acronym is, or their name in Korean is like Sonno Chide or something, and so the acronym is SNSD, even though their name is Girls' Generation. It's all very confusing. I wouldn't get too invested in figuring out all that stuff. Ghostface Killa, Method Man, Red Man, Electrode, Diglett, Nidoran, Mankey. Quarter note. I don't know if it's a monster of a pile. There's a couple cards I'd rather not play, but we're playing a triple. I could update our record, I guess. We're playing a triple Horn of the Gods. And we have such winners as Impetuous Sunchaser in the deck.
It has been a very long while since I've seen a 54-minute round.
Dingus Kapul, I also wouldn't say that Magic is based around luck, but it's part of the game.
Oh, absolutely.
It's absolutely part of the game. But it is not a game of luck. I would say it is much more a game of skill. But luck is a very big factor. I mean, the easiest thing is if it's always a game of luck, then why do you always see the same people doing well at Pro Tours and GPs?
Because they're really lucky.
They're just super lucky.
They're just super lucky. Zangief.
So I subscribed earlier today and it didn't show up in chat, says Hedronic. Let me see if it's on our thing. No, it's not. See, that happens sometimes and it's so annoying. Well, Hedronic, thank you so much for subscribing. Welcome to the runners, Hedronic. Thank you for subscribing. We know that happens and we're sorry, but sometimes if the chat doesn't register it, then we can't see it and then our thing can't see it and it's all a mess. And then James has disappeared.
Where did I go?
James is gone.
Dear God. You can still hear me, but you can't see me.
I'm going right through him. My hand just right through James.
Does this actually work that well?
Yeah, you're completely fucking invisible.
Oh, really? Yeah. Sweet.
Gone.
Is it noticeable that I'm gone? Like, is it like... No, there's clearly a sheet there, or is it actually doing a really good job?
It's doing a very good job, actually. There's like maybe there's like one little bit... I think the background is helping, but yeah. No, you're really... there we go. Got a little crease there.
Sweet.
Yeah, you're gone.
So then I can just be like...
Yep. Spoopy ghost. Spoopy ghost.
Yeah, no. That's sweet.
Evil Smurf. What would AKB-48 be as a magic card? It'd be like the Tetravis or the Pentavis, right? It would be like a thing that just goes into like 48 1-1s. Or probably 0-1s. The Architect Unstructured. The next podcast is going up soon. I've got to add the card images to it. Okay, so I've been adding the card images manually to the last couple tap taps. Also, apologies that they were too big in the last one. This should be the last one I have to do that on because our new computer is finally in transit to here and we can add them on as we do it because the computer we're using to record them right now can't handle that. So... depends on how late I want to stay up, basically. I could do it after my stream or I can do it tomorrow afternoon. We'll see.
48 0-1s that can pay one and tap one to mill or tap to mill.
It seems like a windmill slam in draft. All right. That seems fine. We'll keep it. Oh, wait. We have no white. That's fine.
Who cares? We can play our Sun Chaser.
We can play the worst card in our deck. I don't know if it's the worst card in our deck. It's pretty bad. Like, it's not a great card.
All right. Here we go.
I mean, I guess Karnassus knows our deck, but he's only really cheating if he's watching the stream while he's playing against us, which he still isn't doing. So. Correct. Otherwise, I don't really care.
Oh, Karnassus lost, too.
Ah, boo.
How many computers are in the moon base? 1, 2, 3. 3.
4 if you count the other PC.
Oh, yeah.
But it's not plugged in.
It's not plugged in.
No.
3 plugged in and running 4 total.
Oh, Laserbeak's Fury. I like the post-added cards, too. That's why I do them. But we would rather have the opportunity or the option to add them as we were talking.
Yes. Which we were doing.
It also cuts down the post processing to nothing. I'm going to play the Reveler here because this thing can attack next turn anyway.
Yep.
And this gets in for 2 damage next turn. I guess 1 damage this turn and 1 damage next turn is basically the same. Well, no, it can't. All right. Fair enough. You got me. Yeah. We got the mirror match, everybody.
Clearly he is already winning, though.
Best magic card ever, best flavor ever. It's one of my favorites. Let's find out. Oh, yeah. Chub Toad at the tour. Run away quick, or you're on no more. Chub Toad. Boy, that's a beating.
Jeez.
That's going to really hurt us next turn.
Next turn, yeah.
All right. Yeah. I mean, we can play the Cyclops and trade with it, but still, that's rough.
Or we could do that.
Or we could just kill it.
That actually might be worth it.
Yeah, I think we just kill it.
Yep.
Don't have this. Don't have it.
Oh, you had it. You had to say don't have it. Oh my god.
All right, well, I guess we planes and excoriate.
Yep.
Just top, in the right order, though. Wow. It's a race. It's a race. Our opponent is weaning.
Jesus.
Wow. Rough boots. All right, well, next turn we get to play the Cyclops and keep up our own mortal hard war.
Ooh, he didn't have anything. That's kind of nice.
It's no saying he didn't have anything.
End of turn. Syrian blood. Jesus.
So we lose. Why didn't I...
What?
God.
What did you do?
I didn't save... I could have saved it. It's only 2 damage. It's not 3 damage. It's 2. I could have saved it.
Oh.
God, I'm just like master puntsman today. Just really bad. That wasn't meant to be the Mario voice. It's a rat race reference.
Well, we kill it.
Just die. Go away. Nobody likes you.
And then just, I think...
Does anything have haste in this format? I guess this guy, we're dead anyway, so...
Yeah, I mean, there are other cards that have haste. I mean, we have the 2/2 with haste that can scry and stuff like that. Like, there's a couple. I don't think it's worth it. I think you just attack.
You seem pretty competent at magic, but if I could humbly add one piece of advice, it would be to win more.
Hey, we won the last match. That's not that...
Okay. It's
kind of meh.
I'll take it. Neat.
How much does the bestow on the Eidolon cost? 7? 6.
We can bestow it.
Get in for...
But I'd rather gain some life here. But I don't think we can gain enough. Yeah, we can't actually gain that much.
All right. If we bestow it, we get in for 4?
Yep. Let's do it.
Yeah. Because he is actually... If he needs to kill us this turn or get a flyer out here, he's dead.
That's true. Or just burn us.
Yeah, I mean, there are many ways.
Ooh,
nah, that's it.
That was one of the ways. All right. This game, I'm not going to throw away. He said, hopefully. Running it back. Abandoned hope. Yeah, where's Worth with the abandoned hope?
Yeah.
You know, we found some in the office, some actual abandoned hope cards. I was like, has he been here? Did he come in here? Better hand. Sure.
Just gotta get that turn, that draw the Sun Chaser off the top.
All right, fine.
And yeah, you keep this. I think this is fine.
We got this guy on 4 anyway. Go, Sun Chaser. Major Cade, I don't tend to go full tilt. I tilt out like Cam does. I just sort of go... I get very disappointed in myself. Well, that doesn't quite do it, but it... We're on curve.
Yep.
Rilla.
Oh, that's actually... Okay.
All right, sweet.
That's pretty good.
You gonna top it? You gonna bottom it? Top it, bottom it. What you gonna do?
Bottom.
Neat.
That's sweet. Aww.
Aw, the rollicker.
That's annoying.
Do we want to just trade this? And swing?
I don't know if it's worth it.
I mean, he's behind. We get this thing out. I think it's okay.
Yeah, okay.
Hey, Timurat just subscribed. Timurat, thank you for subscribing.
I put my head in this bag.
Get on the head in the bag. Welcome, Timurat. Welcome to the runners. And thank you. Aggro, 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 aggro. Yotsby, no, I did not see the end of XCOM yesterday. Such crash, much tilt. Did XCOM crash? That'd be awful.
I don't think so. I thought he won.
Or did it just go really badly? No, that was no, he posted that from home.
Oh.
Like he was he posted that saying, just so everyone knows.
I can do this.
Yeah.
Interesting. Interesting. Very interesting.
Good evening, Frozen. We're doing well. I'm doing well, I think. Oh.
Very interesting.
You don't know what he did.
He played the same guy we had, the butcher guy.
All right. I guess you can see through a hole in that thing.
I can see through a hole in this thing.
All right. Bounce. Sadly, we needed a land there, but so be it.
The game crashed 6 times? Jesus Christ.
Really? Wow. That sucks. Every time during the cutscene, he couldn't skip. That's awful. Wait, crash repeatedly on the final cutscene? So wait, did he beat it?
Hey, he does have a haste.
Oh, that guy.
Yeah.
All right, I forgot about that guy. That's fair. That's unfortunate, because that guy's going to untap, and then he can just make... 3 ones forever, which he might do.
We could also just kill it if we draw a land here.
We could. I don't know if that's worthwhile. We can also just do this. No, then we have to tap our creatures. That's dumb. So we could play this, take... This is going to be 4, that'll be 6. And then if he pays, that'll be 9. Yeah, I guess we just kill this.
Yeah, I think we do.
All right. Eat it. Go away. Nobody likes you. I don't like you either.
Ugh. Rotating through feed dump hats would be such a pain.
Rotating what?
Through feed dump hats for every new subscriber.
Ugh.
I'd have to go downstairs.
No!
Oh.
We don't even have that many feed dump hats. Like, or we don't even have all the feed dump hats that we've ever used.
Yeah. True story.
This is a weird race we're having.
It's not really a race anymore. We can't attack. Although we get a 5-2 next turn.
Mm-hmm. Or.
Or we draw a land and we get
or a Faragax giant.
Yeah.
Which he probably wants to give us the 5-5.
Damn. Hey! That.
Two can play it. Well, I can't, actually. No. But two could play at that game. All right, I guess we can play this guy. Probably just trade for that.
Yeah. I mean, next turn we could even do the lightning volley on the Pegasus to kill the Eidolon.
Yep. What? Oh.
I think I need to go back and watch this.
Damn it.
Stream. Oh, God.
We did. That's a really good card.
Yeah. Oh, dear God.
We are actually dead.
Yeah, we are. Because we can't block, can we? All right. Well, that went quickly. So I guess we could double Q.
Yep. Do, do, do. So, triple BNG 8-4?
Sure.
Yeah. Boop. No one's in the queue because it's a weird thing.
Is the okay? They're joining. I was gonna say maybe just go to
Mize.
Us another Swiss, but Eh. This makes more sense. Boy, that was quite a... That was quite a kicking. Yay, says CCC Fudge. Hopefully for the double Q, not for the fact that we just lost.
Turn into ad.
Huh?
Ad.
Yeah, we'll play a commercial while we wait for this Q to fire. BRB.
Burb. Burbity burb.
Hey.
We back!
For those of you, some people might still be seeing ads.
I keep getting SeaWorld and that stupid applesauce ad. I like how there's a stupid applesauce ad. Anyways, we're first picking Pinnacle of Rage here, guys. And then we're second picking... Wow. That, yeah, that.
I don't know.
I mean, Fall of the Hammer is, I think, probably... I think I take Fall of the Hammer. I think Bolt's, like, third here. Like, I think it drags me. Like, I take Fall of the Hammer over Bolt any day.
Yeah. Yeah, that's fair.
And I think I take Fall of the Hammer over the archetype as well.
Really? This guy's really good.
Yeah. But Fall is... I really like Fall. And it keeps us in red, which is nice.
That's true. I guess that is double white. Okay, everybody should be back now.
And then... So, like, Nyxborn Triton is pretty good, actually.
Yep. It's that or, like, the Oathsworn?
I don't mind the Oathsworn. I mean, he's the same as all the other green...
Works well with Fall of the Hammer.
Yeah, like, I like him kind of a lot, but the double green this early is tricky. I haven't really drafted Izzet very much in this format, like Theros or anything, so.
Fish Gumbo's right. Like, we're not stuck with red pick two, but I think that, I don't think, like, it's honestly a pretty close pick to me. Like, Fall of the Hammer is really, really, really good.
Yeah.
I think I like the Triton here.
That's fine. Yeah, I'm down with that. Yeah, I think it's either the Triton or the Oathsworn, so. I mean, we're going to open Xenagos next pack, so maybe we do take the Oathsworn.
We are? I didn't know that.
Yeah. I just got the call. Okay, well, there's a
Six.
Dunk. yeah, I mean...
It's like Asphyxiate is probably the best card here.
Yeah, but after taking the Triton, I'm okay with taking the Helix here.
Helix, so good.
Yeah, I mean, there's a Giant, there's a Skirmisher.
Give Helix.
I'm not actually even paying attention to the Pegasus this time, so...
No.
All right. Yeah.
Twitch has been giving you political ads. That sounds awful.
That's weird.
Yeah, we're double queuing. We lost that round so quickly, we figured we could get away with it.
Another Triton.
Yeah, I think so. This guy's really good. Like, this guy's good. This guy's really good.
Yeah. No, I'm okay
but
with another Triton.
This guy's also good, so yep. I'm totally fine with that. This seems very expensive.
Yes, it is.
Also, that thing is big. Look at the size of that boat.
Yeah.
That thing is big.
Well, there's a Kraken, so... I would expect it to be pretty big. All right.
Nullifino.
Yeah, I mean, I don't mind Stratuswalk either, but I think you take Nullify over Stratuswalk, so...
Yeah. Hi, MI89325. Beta client, indeed. God, it's the same cards.
Take the Stratuswalk, I guess. I don't know. I mean,
I don't want to run this guy.
No, don't run that guy. He really isn't good.
Yeah,
he's in the other deck because he's kind of funny, and I really want him to combo off with the Pegasus. But
all right,
no, you take the Stratuswalk.
Okay, I'll take this guy.
Yeah,
this guy's really strong.
Uh,
Okay, I could take a serpent here.
Yeah. I kind of, and with like,
we got like,
we have it with Stratus Walk, and
that's a good synergy.
Yep. Draw cards. I mean, that's the kind of card that you want to bounce with it.
Okay, I guess we'll take the Oathsworn again.
Yeah. I mean, if maybe we're blue green and,
yeah, maybe we only have the two red cards. We haven't, the only red cards that came around that whole pack was like a whole lot of Fiery Temper and a Impetuous Sun Chaser. So this thing is all right, sure. You know what? I'm gonna take a second one of these over this Reveler.
Yep.
This one is an 8/4. Recall. Yeah, this Oathsworn's actually quite good with Retraction Helix because it's a single mana. Mm-hmm. How is what possible? Oh, there was someone spamming who was Turbo? I didn't even see it. Oh, yep, missed it completely. These are all terrible, so I guess I'll take a Springleaf Drum. I mean, not terrible. This guy's, I guess, fine. It's a Pillar Field Ox, but this guy's not great. Fine. Actually, I'm more worried about this guy.
Sure.
You're also terrible. I asked Marshall, by the way. That is Elmer. Having been killed by a harpy.
I don't believe it. Elmer can't die.
Well, Elmer got swept away in the downpour as well. Like, Elmer dies pretty frequently. So, Fate Unraveler is a good card. I quite like... I had two of them in a deck the other day.
That being said, I like the Nyxborn Wolf.
Nyxborn Wolf, there's a Sudden Storm, which I actually like. At least in triple BNG.
Mm-hmm.
I've played with it and had it played against me, and it's been pretty good. Yeah, I think the Nyxborn Wolf here.
Yeah.
I think we're moving more towards blue-green, which is fine. Because the red cards in here are fine, but this is also good.
Yeah, take the 3-drop. Although I think we're piling up on 3s. Now, they are... Ooh, done. Ding. Slam it.
Oh, like, man. We could wheel one of these?
Holy crap, yeah. Wow. Absolutely.
There's another Pinnacle of Rage, which is pretty funny, but this thing...
Yeah, that thing is insane. Card is... Absolutely bonkers.
All right, red that to the board anyway. I mean, I'll keep Follow the Hammer visible, but that thing's super good. Henge Guardian, what deck in Born of the Gods Theros Limited do you want a Satyr whatever that is just a 1/1 after he mills you for 4? Like, I appreciate he's good for...
that, we don't take it. It's too late. Raised by wolves.
Yeah, it's good for splashing. Why weren't you there earlier so we could take those stupid satyr guys and actually, like, maximize fixing? All right. We're taking this.
Manticore needs to show up...
In the first pack.
In the first pack or be pack one... Or pack two, pick one.
Yeah.
We can't make this work.
I want to get this back.
Yeah.
I like this guy a lot. All right.
We're not taking it.
No, we have the combo. Look, Raised by Wolves, Floodtide Serpent. We have the combo.
We have to take our...
We're not doing... We'll do it someday. Believe me. We've got months of Born of the Gods.
Yeah.
We will Chromanticore, but today is not that day.
We have to take our preview card.
Today we are... Yeah, this was our preview card. This was our guy.
We don't care what you have to say.
We're not doing it.
You're not our dads.
You are not all of you our dads. Disciple.
Yeah. All right. I'm not super crazy about the Disciple, but he's okay.
I like him. I mean, it'd be...
No, it's Disciple.
Yeah, all right. More like Underwhelming Wave, am I right?
Boom.
I mean, we have a Serpent.
Yeah.
Right?
We get him with that.
Right? Yeah.
Of course, then we need to return enchantments for him to do anything.
So I guess, like, Sudden Storm?
Oh, crap. Some people are claiming to be my dad now. I'm scared.
Wow, you have a lot of dads.
Yeah. All right.
We aren't already three colors.
We had two red cards.
We have this double red card and then Follow the Hammer. We're not two colors. We're not three. We're two colors.
I don't know. Just a Storm?
Yeah, I think probably
just Sudden Storm. Storm's fine.
It's fine. Ooh. Wow. Vortex Elemental. This thing's really good. It's super annoying. No one wants to attack into that.
Yeah.
It just you play it. And people are like,
I mean, you need to have the mana open, but
yeah.
All right, get in their deck. Divination.
Yeah, over, I think divination over.
I'm just looking at what else.
Starbreaker. I don't know. Actually, maybe this thing.
I mean, I guess
it's another thing we don't mind returning with Floodtide Serpent. It like turns any guy into a mana dork. Although, All right, fine.
I like drawing cards.
Div. Unravel the Aether.
Yeah.
Or Mortal's Resolve.
Probably the Resolve.
So this just makes enchantment creatures go away.
Yeah.
Oh, F. Round three of that Swiss. Quick, what do you guys think? Mortal's Resolve or Unravel the Aether? Take fixing for when you wheel Chromanticore.
I don't know. You got 2 seconds, though.
Crap, fine. I guess we take another sudden storm. Probably not going to main deck both of them. Cool.
That was it stacked back, right?
Yeah, I'm disappointed that we only got the Deepwater Hypnotist.
So he's back. Chatting. He's actually chatting with us, so.
Whoops, hang on. Nope.
Also, this hand is terrible. It's actually not bad. Keep it. Another. Crypsis,
I think Crypsis. I dig Crypsis. Do we mulligan this?
No, keep it.
All right.
I think it's actually not. I mean, it's right on the brink. Like, I'm not. Yeah, all right. It got better.
Sure.
Yeah. Badger.
I don't think we're main decking.
We're not playing the badger.
I don't think we're main decking either of those, actually.
You can either you take both of them out, actually.
Oh, sick. Look at this curve, though.
Yep.
This curve. Pass back. All right, fine. Can't actually attack with our storm color, but we're still playing it. Oh, F. I didn't realize that was going through already. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we opened this thing, so that's not quite like Xenagos. Maybe that's maybe the winds are murky, and that's what you saw.
Yeah.
So I really hope we get back Chorus, Fairy's Band Tromper, or this thing, but it doesn't seem likely. The Chorus of the Tides is really good,
really,
but
like
this thing's bonkers. Nice. Oh, sick, love it,
nice,
love it.
Although there is another badger.
I know there is.
There is another badger.
That's true. Ooh, Flitter Step.
Yep.
Flitter Step's real good.
There is another badger, though. I'm just throwing that out there.
There is another
That could badger. Be our third badger. There is... Oh, damn it. There wasn't a badger there. I was really hoping. Helix.
Yeah. Helix all day. Helixes are so good. All
right, so that's 23 right now. That deck actually looks pretty sick.
Yeah. Oh, we're getting rollicked.
All right. Rickrolled.
Yeah, no blocks.
I was sad. I pulled the foil Rickroll, but he's not actually going into the popper cube. So he's just not good enough.
I guess Eternity Snare. Like, it's basically removal.
Yeah.
I mean, 6 mana, but so was Sip of Hemlock. Sip of Hemlock killed it, but this makes it go away forever.
Yeah, we're not playing any of the, these other cards, so.
We might play this.
Yeah. Right now we need to make a cut, though, so.
Mm-hmm. I don't know what. Probably one of our 2-drops.
Mono badger.
Deck could be sicker, badgers and such. Deck could be sicker. We could have more badgers, it's true.
Need more badgers.
Praise Helix, indeed. I like that. That's a really relevant joke right now. I dig that, actually. Oh,
Demilock.
I was excited to see this.
Yeah.
But Demilock. Yeah, we'll take the Demilock.
And it's foiled.
It's a foil Demilock. You get to foil destroy a target non-creature permanent.
Or three foil plus one.
I mean,
plus
this
one
fits our curve better. But the Demilock's really strong. Yeah. And yeah, we can cut a five. Whoa!
Snake. Because I don't think we want another. Well,
do we want another three or another five? I love the snake, but
I guess we do want another three. Actually, we're kind of heavy on the fives right now.
How many we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 ways to target. So yeah or 9.
Although that would be
10. Yeah.
Sure. Or maybe we just take the third Triton.
I don't know. What do you guys think?
I don't know if they're going to be able to catch up here.
Probably not. I think I'm just going to take the Oathsworn.
Another Triton. Take the Triton.
All right. We'll take the Triton.
Sure.
Let's do it.
Okay.
I guess this time I take the Oathsworn? I really like the snake. We have so many ways.
I mean, we're not. We don't need to play the Floodtide Serpent. We could cut that. That's our weakest of the fives right now.
Get to do some cool combos there, but
mm-hmm.
And return the Raised by Wolves. Yeah, let's take the
Wham Sauce. Just subscribed.
Wham Sauce, thank you for subscribing.
Welcome, Wham Sauce.
Welcome to the Runners. Or we could take another Nullify.
Nah.
Snake.
Yeah. Sure. Ooh!
Wow.
Snap. Yep. Done. Cool. Badger. No, don't take the Badger. Well, that's got another divination.
Sideboard?
I guess, yeah.
I mean, I don't want a second divination. We're never
Unless
gonna
you
win
want the favor now.
I mean, we have some expensive stuff. Yeah. Sure.
I don't know.
I mean, maybe we're winning any of that.
Badger.
Eye gouge actually kills something. Sure.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, let's go back and play the game. Come back and build this deck.
Don't!
Jerk.
Our opponent, thankfully, is a viewer and knows we're double queuing, so. Favor is really terrible. Well, we probably aren't playing it or anything else in that pack, so whatever. All right. Next turn we get to do horrible things with this Ghostblade Eidolon, so that's fun. I keep alt-tabbing out of the window to look at your other game. Arnf, take five. All right. You know what? Get in there. I'll chump with the Faragax Giant if I have to.
Derber Crew.
Next turn we get to put a Ghostblade Eidolon on the Akroan Skyguard and hit him in the air for six.
Seems decent.
I'm pretty happy with that, yeah. Do we just take five? I don't think he can kill us.
Yeah, take it. What you gonna do? Okay, play another one of those guys.
Wow. I still sweet, think he loses.
Sweet board, bro.
So that'll be six in the air. Eats that. Blocks that. Doesn't die. Okay, so we can't actually attack with these two.
No,
guys.
You just, yeah. All right. Bestow we'll up, attack, pass.
You lose. No, he's not dead, because if we attack with all three, he can put the Butcher on the Stormcaller, chump the Faragax Giant with an Ixborn Rolliker, and then kill us. So, yeah. I hope he calls his deck the Rollicking Butchers, because that's all that's happening. You were very correct, Watson only Twick. Fudge.
Yeah.
+3/+3. So, read this card. Until end of turn, target creature gets +3/+3 and gains trample, and whenever this creature deals combat damage to a player, draw that many cards.
He's going to draw a lot of cards.
He sure is.
He's going to draw 3 cards.
Yeah, and we're going to take 6?
That's fine.
I think that's what we take.
Well, hold on.
Does it matter? It's 3.
And then they're mitigating 5?
Yeah, so we take 3 there?
We're taking 6, yeah.
Yeah.
And he's got no mana.
All right.
So I think we're okay.
Spark Jolt. He's drawing cards. He could go land.
Did he play land this turn?
No. But Spark Jolt also is not in this format.
Yeah, it's not. There's a lot of cards, though.
We win! Gross.
That was all right. Really close, though.
Let's build this deck real quick. Done. No. Obviously, we have too many stuff. All right, let's take out the favor. I think we could do without Crypsis.
Yep.
Though I don't want to cut too many ways to target our guys. I like Eternity Snare and both the Helixes. Maybe take out Sudden Storm, and we probably want one or two less creatures. Least exciting creature. It'd be nice to have a 2-drop, but let's put 2 of these guys over here. This guy's a 5-drop as well. Maybe cut this?
I could see cutting that.
I like drawing cards, but we do need to make some cuts. Yeah, let's cut the Hypnotist. One more cut. What do you think? Sudden Storm?
Yeah, I think so. It's either that or the Flutter Step Eidolon. What's that do again?
Unblockable. Well, can't be blocked.
Yeah.
Bestows, can't be blocked. We have a lot of things to bestow on it.
Yeah, all right.
We can raise it by wolves.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, okay, I say Sudden Storm. I mean, yeah, we could cut a Triton too.
That's true.
Just go down to 2 of them. I think that's fair.
I kind of like 15 creatures. Yeah, let's cut the storm.
All right.
Whoops, no. Well, actually, it's relevant too. 9/8. That makes sense to me. Yeah, that seems good. Now then, back over here. Right, this doesn't have any sideboarding options, really.
Not really.
Okay. Take the Hypnotist over a 3rd Triton. I could see that, actually. Thinking about it now, I could see that. Hypnotist, like that.
Yeah, okay, I'm okay with that.
You're right.
Yeah, you keep those.
All right, all you want to have happen is to go Pegasus into Impetuous Sun Chaser.
Pretty much.
I really hope we can make that happen for you in this game.
Nope.
Damn. I'm sorry. We tried.
This is the worst day of my life.
We tried so hard and got so far. But in the end, the Immortal says... God damn it. The Immortal says Crypsis over Mortal's Resolve. You were not on curve, sir.
Jerk. So you get left behind.
You ass. Someone said Crypsis over Mortal's Resolve. So this makes the thing indestructible. This gives it protection from creatures and untaps it. I don't know. We actually haven't submitted this deck at all. We will submit. I don't know, what do you think?
I like Mortal's Resolve, so I don't know.
Alright. If anything needs to get cut, it's Eternity Snare. Pretty sure that card isn't good. I mean, it takes a creature away.
Ooh.
That's good. Okay. Like, it takes a creature off effectively off the board, and that seems fine.
Oh, we have no attacks. Really?
No. So do we play the...
Skyguard, I guess?
Or no, I think we play the Stormcaller to use up more of our mana. Yeah. Yep. Yeah. Not amazing. Oh yeah. That's fine. Yeah, I agree with Nirvana. Eternity Snare was crap when it was first printed, but is reasonable removal in this format. Does it not tap? Oh, it just doesn't untap.
Yeah.
Oh. That's less good than I thought, but...
I mean, yeah, because now it's... Maybe it doesn't all that
and
great.
It draws a card, too.
Yeah.
I mean, I'd be okay with taking this out and putting one of the storms in.
Yeah, maybe. I mean... We're not, like, super, super aggro, so...
Gah.
Jesus. All right, this game is pretty much over.
Oh, that's true. It's pretty good on things that have guys bestowed on them, because then they don't get the guys.
Yeah.
So do we double block one of these things? Throw our guys away? Double block this guy and trade
we can,
2-for-1?
We can bolt the other guy later. Yeah, do
it. All right. Sorry, Pegasus. You were fun, but yeah, you gotta kill that thing.
All right, submit the deck. Let's try this.
All right. That's not the thing that I wanted it to be. Alright. So many Kragma Butchers.
Yeah.
Is Chromanticore the only creature with vigilance in Triple Born of the Gods? Crazy.
Possibly. I don't actually. I can't know. I don't know off the top of my head. Oh, yeah. Brymass has vigilance, doesn't he?
Damn it. Yeah, that's true. And all of his kitties. Jeez. And the Vanguard of Brymass does as well.
Yeah.
All right. Guess we're taking 6.
Yes. Yes, Maya, we did lose. Jeez.
That's just a guy, but still. All right. Take your 5 to the dome, since that's what you have to do, basically. But the next turn, you can do the thing, and... Oof, we're super dead here. Luckily, this is only game 2, but still. What's happening over here? That's a keep.
Yep.
Yeah, let's keep that. Yeah, we're not attacking that. I mean, I guess we could since we're... Are we going to take this damage anyway? I don't know. We probably could have attacked there. Oh, them spam bots.
They're stinkers.
Wait, what?
What?
No.
Oh, God.
It's a little awkward, but fine with it. Wait, what? What?
Whoa.
He didn't do the thing? Okay, all right. Well, I guess we double block that. All right, time for more double blocks. At least this is a 2-for-2 this time. All these double blocks. Well,
ugh. If that isn't just the worst feeling in the world.
I mean...
Killing a Sun Chaser with a Rickroller on him.
We kind of have to, don't we?
I know we do, but dear God.
All right. My 2-drop is better than your 2-drop. Though I do want to start drawing more land.
Yeah, if we could just go land now.
Mm-hmm.
One of them being blue. That'd be kind
of
sick.
Two of them. Or yeah, sorry, one of them. Because we already have one.
Yeah.
Yeah, come on in. Not blocking that. are you doing? Oh, okay.
There's our
neat. And nothing. What?
All right, well, that's...
Oh, if only we had creatures to use the lightning volley on.
Yeah.
Oh, come on.
Can't even cast it.
Come on. A mountain there would have been sweet. So we got to trade the Skyguard for... Actually, no, we're dead.
WTB Flames of the Firebrand.
Yeah, come on in.
Pass your turn.
Next turn we get to Trump. All right. Well, there's all that land we wanted. I guess I don't want to trade this.
No, you don't want to trade that, I don't think.
The next turn... Whoa. You know what? Sure. Let's see what you got. Let's let him do it.
Okay.
No. I'm not paying your tribute. I'm not buying into your blackmail. I bet you don't even have anything.
And then wait for it.
So many things he could have.
I've heard that, like, a lot of the time, it's unlikely for someone to actually have that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, all right. Well, there's also that. All right, bye, goodbye, bye, Ferris Band Tromper. It's okay. We get to start doing cool stuff. Is he just going to swing out here? He probably will. Except for that.
Yeah, because we could just eat him.
Yeah. Seven. Should we trade here?
I feel like we probably should.
For, I guess, nice. The highest power?
Yeah.
You're right. Okay. Demolock?
Yeah.
That'll hold down the ground quite nicely. And hopefully get him off his... Just, like, get to randomly destroy a land. Oh, it's his combat. Sorry. Damn it. Oh, he didn't pay for the Nixsmith. That... Oh, because we're dead anyway.
Yeah.
Oh. Shoot. Well, dang it. You know you could have blocked that guy all day. The Oracle of Bones? He's a 3/1. Oh, you mean still traded for him. Yeah, okay, that's true. I guess if I'd thought that far ahead. Let's take him off black, I guess. Most of his deck seems to be black. Although this makes it... He could cast Bolt. That's true, I guess. If we hadn't paid... Yeah, well, there we go.
Wow, yeah.
Dang it. I guess if we hadn't paid the tribute, we still just could have traded, so... That was maybe a stupid move. All right, well, snake.
Yeah.
Well, actually, Siren might have been a good pick there, too. This weird, weird format. All right, we're trying for it.
One more try.
One more kick at the can here. Well, he still hasn't hit his... He still... Like, we have kept him off land pretty effectively.
He doesn't have white, so he's just a 2/2, basically.
Yeah. But the other 2/2 can't block, so... Hmm. Okay. But, okay, we can't play both of those, which is unfortunate. Archetype still blocks Ashiok's Adept, but no, let's just play Siren.
Yep.
What now?
You just get a 4/4.
Nice. I'm okay with that.
All right, come on. Damn it.
All right, we might actually get to cast that one this game. We have yet to cast it, even though I was talking up how good it is.
Which?
Pinnacle of Rage.
Oh, yeah.
It is really good. We just haven't had opportunity to cast it yet. It's a fair criticism, Rocket Man. Though we did just see Asphyxiate. There's a lot of double black cards, too. We did just see Asphyxiate, so...
He's got the plus one, dude. Indestructible.
If he does, he's gonna have a bad day.
Oh, no, he has the... Oh, right, because he can tap for anything. Dominated.
Still counts as during our turn. Womp, 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 womp. Right, sorry. And remind me that Mobman started to chat. Siren's great. Ooh, didn't attack. Still off land. Good. All right, we can play both of these guys. Does that mean we actually get an attack here?
I don't know. Maybe. I mean, those things will just... If we attack here, they just chump.
Right.
And we're just throwing those creatures away.
Whereas there's a possibility that next turn we can archetype and, like, we All right. I think we just... Yeah, pass for one more turn. We'll see what happens. What did Mom say? Huh. Yep.
Oh, yeah. Low Pegasus for sure.
And the Excoriate?
Yeah, take it. All top right. And then top. No! That shuts down our Pegasuses so well.
That was our whole plan.
Alright, so.
Play after attacks. 4/4 flying. What about... What? Oh, yes. Okay. I think we just play the... I'm going to attack with this thing, though. I think we just play the Farragax Giant this turn.
Yep.
Especially right. If he'd played the Grave Robber Spider, I'd be tempted to just do the Pegasus, but...
All right, back to the other game.
Grizzly Transformation. No! Aww, we have to discard a card.
All right.
That's unfortunate. And this guy now has Intimidate, so he gets through. And our opponent has drawn a card and hit his land. All right. So 3-turn clock from Ashiok's Adept there. That's not helpful.
That's not good. Probably attack for 4 here. Well, maybe not. Ugh.
I think we do. I don't mind trading one of these. Like, even if we're doing something. My friend said Grave Robber Spider was worse than Giant Spider.
What?
It's exactly the same, but has an off-color ability if you so desire.
Ugh. Back, there goes our 7/7. And actually, that's dead.
Well, aren't we glad...
Oh, no, it's not dead.
It's not dead. We just have to chump. See, aren't we glad we kept him off double black for a little while longer there? Not that any of our creatures were tapped at any point during that, but the point is I had reasons.
Oh, he's not even attacking with the...
Doesn't want to make a straight-up trade, I guess.
No, it doesn't matter. Too little, too late.
Does it not?
No, because he has the Intimidator.
Oh, right, the Intimidator. Right. Okay.
One.
All right. Sucks.
All right. Back to the other game.
Oh. Well, I guess you guys are still getting all the sounds.
Sorry. I completely forgot. I hate being on the other side of this.
You yeah. give him a 7-7, I think.
The 7-7? We can't fight through that. We can maybe double block a 4-4. I think we give him the life.
Nah.
No. I'm not going to pay your tribute. How dare you? Ah, yes. That. Boo. No, I can still get in. Trade for the snake? Okay. You can't play Grave Robber Spider in mono green EDH. That's true.
That is true.
Fair.
I think that's you found the one case where it's not as good as Giant Spider. Although I question what kind of deck you're playing if you're playing Giant Spider in EDH.
It seems fine card.
There's so many better cards that I like.
Yeah, this is Swiss. I don't know if our record is accurate. This is Swiss. Takes it. Alright. And the other one is this is an 8-4. So we are down a game in. I think we can do better against our opponent's deck. I don't know if we want to bring anything in. I'm going to do this. He's got lots of little guys. Let's switch those out.
Yep.
All right. Let's see how that works.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's not bad.
Draw another forest and we're doing pretty good there. I don't much care for that. He's not going to attack with it, is he?
Nope.
No, I didn't think so. All right. That's so annoying that it doesn't actually... So if we...
If you all out attack...
And he can block one of the Pegasus and then we get to do that after combat?
I think that's the play.
Do we all out attack? Because he can just eat the Farragax giant.
It's dying as well, isn't it?
Yeah. It's 3, but then we lose the Farragax giant as well.
Yeah, but we're getting in for 6.
Yeah, all right. Sure.
Wait, if we get in for 6...
Oh, yeah.
He's just dead.
All right, sure. Haha! There's some way that we're winning after this combat.
We think.
Oh. Well, that wasn't quite what I expected. Alright, well, now we just kill both his creatures.
Yeah, do it.
Or I guess we could have done 3 to him and then either Pegasus is lethal next turn, but that also works.
This is way more fun.
Ha-ha!
He's still not dead.
I know. That's the main thing we wanted to do was that.
They're attacking. Does he have a way to kill both of them? Yeah. Oh. Tap, concede. Dang!
It's got that weird bug with the mob man wins. Loading, ready, run was the match.
Yeah. Oh, dear. All right. Back to paying more attention to this.
This 8-4.
Eight, 8-4.
Right. Oh, that is... Boy, do I hope we draw...
Yeah.
...a thing. A forest. That's the thing I was talking about.
Yeah, we really want to draw a forest here. That is the opposite of what I said I really wanted to draw. I'm sorry. I meant we really want to draw an island here.
Oh, man. It looks like our opponent's off their land?
No.
Dang.
Just skip through their first main.
All right.
Hey! Sweet. It worked. Oh, that guy's going to be huge.
Yeah, next turn that guy's going to be raised by wolves.
He's going to be so big.
Hey, mob man. This format's weird. Wow, all right. Fine. We discard this.
Yeah.
Take it. Yeah, you get through.
But guess what? Oh, sick! And you guys wanted us to pick for Manticore.
Raised by wolves.
He's a 5/5, and we have. Oh my god!
What now?
Now I wish we did have the Leviathan, so we could return it and cast it again.
The reason I'm not sending a message with the Vortex Elemental is because of things like Asphyxiate.
Yeah.
That kill untapped creatures.
Really? You want a race? That seems. Not good.
Okay. I got lots of islands, apparently. I mean, you're welcome to attack if you want. Wow.
What?
Okay.
Okay. You can't possibly attack.
If he doesn't and we draw a land, then he's ruined, because then this thing, I forced the block there.
Yeah, okay.
Well, that also works, I guess. So that thing's only 1/1, that thing's only 1/1?
Yeah.
Okay, so what do you say to this? Oh, no, that's too dangerous, actually. I was going to target the Oathsworn with the Retraction Helix, but that's really dangerously plays into... Asphyxiate.
Yes.
So, I mean, without actually the benefit of attacking, right?
Yeah.
So, I don't know. What do you think about just bouncing this guy and swinging with these guys?
Yeah. Because then he has just 2 1/1s, so. Yeah. He is tapped out.
Hey, Mobman just subscribed.
Mobman84.
Mobman, thank you for subscribing. You have waited too long already.
Thank you for subscribing, Mob Man. You're the man of mobs. Alright, do something.
Hold the Oathsworn and Helix. You can asphyxiate in response. What? Asphyxiate is a... Oh, asphyxiate is untapped creature?
Yeah.
Oh. Whoops. Alright, then we're doing this. Sorry, I got confused. I didn't realize Asphyxiate was... I thought it was tapped.
No, that's Excoriate.
No, that's... Yeah. Alright, well... Right, Assassinate is tapped creature. Sorry. Thank you, chat. Thank you. Why are all these dudes making out? They were all bestowed.
They were all making out.
Read the cards. I know! I need to look at the cards! I tell you, Riley had better be super naked for all these links.
What?
It's all the all the spam links are all for naked Riley.
Oh.
Dixon the White returns to us now at the turning of the tide. There should be a magic card named Exfoliate.
Ooh.
Ew.
Exonerate. Oh god, he's casting something.
No.
Oh god.
No. Uh-oh.
Ooh. Oh, that's actually really bad.
Wow, yeah, that's super bad. Oh, wait, no it's not. That's not bad at all, actually.
Oh yeah. Okay.
Watch this. Do 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 do. Do 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 do.
Whoop.
So is this thing still bugged?
I don't know if it was actually bugged or if that was just what's that thing called where you think something and then you see a thing that reinforces it, so you pay attention to that and not things that are against it?
I don't know. Because the idea is that it's the next card, right?
I think. We'll find out. You can double block a wolf. Yeah, double block a wolf. Confirmation bias. Thank you. Yeah, I don't know if that actually happened or if I'm not remembering times when it didn't. But I feel like that definitely happened to me on 3 separate occasions. And then someone in the chat said, oh yeah, that card's totally bugged. But for a second there, I was like, why did our Oathsworn suddenly become a 7/7? Forgetting, of course, that it's number of wolves. What was it, guys? Being dumb? I guess that works, too. Uh-oh!
Ooh.
Uh-oh! If he, like, that could be really bad. If he has a fall of the hammer, that's super gross.
Okay. I think it's...
Wow.
It's bugged.
Wow.
Yeah. So that is absolutely bugged.
Shit.
So Vortex Elemental, what happens is when you crack it to shuffle it and the card that's blocked it back into your library, it puts it...
Second from the top. Yeah.
There is no shuffle. Well, there is a shuffle,
but it ends up second from the top.
Second from the top.
Huh. I've had that happen to my opponents, but I haven't had it happen to me yet. He's going to steal our guy.
Ooh.
I can't tap that.
No, you can't. No.
All right. Interesting. Admiral Mamo just timed himself out. How did you do that? Hey! Okay, so we did end up 2.
Wait,
we won 2 in the Swiss.
I thought that was the second round we just started.
No, that was all 3.
I'm so confused. Yay, we went 2-1 with that deck. That's impressive. I'll take it. All right.
So we can close that.
Neat. Then let's go back to lose this match. Or maybe that's how that...
You could have shuffled in response. It's not... Can you do that when it's...
It's not being blocked, though.
Can you do that at just any time? I thought it was only when a thing was happening to it. Oh, well. My bad.
Go to... Dog.
That's fair.
Foily Syrian blood, too.
Our Oathsworn's so much smaller now.
Yeah. He used to be cool. He used to be raised by wolves, and then his mom and dad were killed.
Yeah. I think he's saving something to target this so that he can kill us eventually.
It doesn't say it has to be attacking or blocking. No, wait, wait, now. Put.
I guess that's... I guess I just inferred that. Put Vortex Elemental and each creature blocking or blocked by it, but it's put Vortex Elemental, eliminate everything else, on top of its owner's library. Oh, yeah, all right. Yeah, okay. Learning about new cards. Welcome to a new set of magic. Yeah, I'm fine with everything else. Although we could board in 2 charging badgers.
Badger.
Okay.
Oh, I thought you were serious.
No. Huh. If no creature is blocking or blocked by it, as its first ability resolves, it alone will be put on top of its owner's library, and that library will be shuffled. You can activate the first ability outside of combat.
Neat. Okay, well, I'll remember that, because I would not have thought I could. I mean, I read the card, and I still wouldn't have known that, so... All right, good
to know. Yeah, I mean, to be fair, Dix,
Like, I just assumed it had to be blocking.
Yeah. I did. Beam block. I did look at the cards. The card is not actually, in that instance, the card is not actually that clear. I could go either way on that card. Trustworthy Pit Dweller. I just realized that the two wolf tokens are the mummy and daddy wolf. Yeah. Flavor even better now. It's true.
That's at least what I've inferred.
Oh, yeah, totally.
Game day is next weekend.
Yep. Got a new episode of Friday Nights about it.
Ooh.
Script approved, by the way.
Sweet.
Has anyone reported the bug? Kind of. I mentioned it to Mike Turian and who else? Ryan, I think? Someone else on Twitter from the Magic team. And I was like, I think this might be bugged. And they were like, oh, that's eerie. I haven't heard anyone else talk about it.
Huh. No, it's confirmed now. Maybe it's a beta thing? Maybe? It could easily be a beta thing, yeah. So, maybe it's not.
Wait, was that the match? No, it's not the match. Okay, no. I didn't think so. I was like, we lost game one, didn't we?
Ooh. Yeah, I guess we keep this.
Yeah, I mean, we've got a bunch of three drops, and we only need one more land to cast any of them, so... Yeah. Man, Searing Blood, such a good card. You're welcome, Deej Ford. Oh, well, there we go. Don't report it until after we're done using it. The update on the 8-4, this is the 8-4.
We are in match one, game three.
Ooh.
Dear God.
And I don't know how it's going to go, to be honest. Because we're going to... Our opponent might just go all in on the... Yep, he's going all in on the... If he attacks with the Nixsmith again, I think we have to trade.
He will not. He is. Oh, he is.
Yeah, I think we have to trade.
Yeah, I think we do.
We can't deal with just an army of these chunguses coming at us. Oh, man.
Yeah, that's a bad trade.
All right. You're a little off the curve there. Though we only got the island last turn. Wish we had one of our four drops here. I guess we just play the other Oathsworn. Oh, well... Triton actually stops that, like, properly.
Yeah.
Be better as a bestow. Yeah, right. If we... I could have attacked. I don't know. If we get another land, then bestowing this on this is going to be fun. Also, Wolf.
Yep. Combo.
Kind of. Oh, sweet. Karnassus posted his...
Oh, nice. Yeah, the Lurebot is always in this channel.
Yeah. Nope, unless it is slowly dying. Yeah, take another three here. Oof. I mean... Yeah. Yeah, okay. Yeah, let's pass. This lets us scry into our fifth land, which we really need. I could save it with the sudden storm. But that's pretty bad.
Yeah, that is really bad.
All right. You get it. Fine. You got me. Cuz the thing is it doesn't doing that means it doesn't actually untap next turn.
We don't get that.
We can't take that. That's rough, but we can't take that. Interesting. All right, good. So do we Demolock?
think so.
These guys still won't untap next turn.
We could also follower and another oath speaker, which would give us 6 next turn, which could be nice.
Wow, we have over 1,000 people watching.
Dear God.
Holy crap. Hey, over 1,000 people. I was surprised. So yeah, we could cure his follower and an oath sworn. We could bestow the oath sworn, remembering that these two guys aren't going to untap on his next turn.
Yeah.
Or we can demolock. This is a tough call. White Fenris says bestow. Someone says demolock. I mean, I wouldn't mind keeping him off land again. Or destroying this, I suppose.
Yeah, I think... probably the demlock. I don't know. this is Twitch Plays Lore, right? The Mana Dork is nice because it lets us do maybe a little bit more next turn, even on top.
It doesn't let us do that much more, though. Three. Really?
Well, it lets us play our Sire. Which could be
useful. Siren, yeah.
Siren, yeah. Because as of right now, we can't play that without...
All right. Let's... Because those guys aren't untapping, let's just use this as a rebuilding turn. We can hopefully demolock the Gorgon's Head some other time.
Yeah.
That guy's scary. Well, we got
that
anyway.
Got that land, okay.
Okay. So now... Now those guys are untapping. Siren?
I think so.
Because he's got to give us the 4-4, right?
Yeah. And I'll take a 4-4. Although... with the Conscriptor, that's kind of scary.
Yeah.
I mean, any of our creatures is kind of scary, though. Like, anything we cast... is going to be bad.
Yeah, it's pretty bad. I don't know. I don't feel great about this game, I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, you give it. Okay, so.
If he just targets the Conscriptor and steals our Siren for the turn, that's...
Pretty much game over.
Pretty bad, yeah. Emberbecky has just subscribed. Emberbecky, thank you for subscribing.
Woo!
Welcome. Welcome to the Runners. James is in the bag.
I like how basically I put the bag on my head and I just Ric Flair and then that's about it now. This is what I've become.
Oh,
what did you do?
Oh, that's even worse because we can't block it.
Oh, jeez. Okay.
We just take 7 here.
Daggered.
Yeah, all right.
New subscriber. Yay, everybody spot the dog. Next scheduled stream.
What is this?
Barf.
Wait, what?
What?
That guy of all... I guess just getting the blocker out of the way.
Yeah. Tap him.
This?
Ha! That was worth it. Even though... Moral victory, I guess. Dear sweet baby Jesus. All right, so we can't block 7 of it.
Can't block either of those. So we're going to 5 regardless.
So we blocked the... crap.
So trade.
And then chump. Yeah.
And go to 2.
Yeah.
Hooray!
We can totally get out of this, guys. Totally get out of this. We just need to draw this card. Damn it. I was hoping for at least something a little bit more exciting than an island.
See, this just kills us.
Yeah. Well.
Well, we tried.
We tried.
I'm attacking anyway just to send a message.
We got a couple... We got 2 drafts in.
Yeah.
That's not bad. Excuse me. Oh, that's just mean.
Why that?
Yeah,
why not us?
Oh, God. Oh, you still had all the.
Yeah, just like BT dubs.
Haha, I get to eat your Cyclops then. How do you like that? You chump. We didn't get any good cards out of that.
No, that was a kind of a
poor
draft. All right, guys. That'll do it for the magic portion of this evening.
Yeah. So we're going to go offline, run some ads on the way out. I guess we finished the day 2-2. And then I will be back in about 10 minutes with Resident Evil 6, where we're actually having fun because we just don't care anymore. Don't forget, aka Resident Evil Man Filleting Giraffe, which, for those who are unfamiliar with it, RE6 logo. There we are.
He is filleting a giraffe.
Get view, open image, there. There.
That is a man.
Anyway, so
garbling a giraffe.
Yeah, and I'll be doing that for the next several hours. Thank you so much for joining us for the Magic Times. Thank you to our new subscribers. If you aren't following the channel and are enjoying it, please do follow. Just click the follow button down there. It's easy to do. It's free. Lets us know that you guys are watching. And yeah, we will we'll be back more drafting at least next Thursday, though. What with it being release week and all, there might be might have an opportunity to do some more magic over the weekend. And yeah.
CardKingdom.com.
CardKingdom.com. Thank you so much for sponsoring our stream. And yeah, thanks everyone for watching. Like I said, going to go offline. The stream will go down for about 10 minutes while I set up the Xbox, and then we'll be back. So take the opportunity to go and get a snack and go to the bathroom. I know I will. And we'll see you later. Thanks so much.
Bye, guys.
Later.